Hey guys, this is Mohit Fotenika. This is going to be a video series that will be an introduction to fusion and node-based compositing in general. I guess most people are familiar with layer-based compositing in softwares like Aftereffects and Hitfilm. However, Fusion, Nuke, even Blender uses node-based systems. Both layer-based and node-based systems has its positives. Something like After Effects has its advantages in motion graphics. As you get to film and advanced level of compositing, it is much more easier, faster and sophisticated to work in a node-based system. Nodes can be intimidating at first, but it's really very easy to work with them. You just have to give yourself a chance with it. Once you open Fusion, this is what we get. This area is called the flow area, where we can add the nodes. Here we have the console, timeline and spline editor. Go to the flow. If you see, these are our two viewers. We also have different layouts. Now if we want, we can change this look to a single view. You have a single viewer, double view, single view, which is an expanded one, or go for this one. So let's go to the default. Here we have the basic tools and this is the timeline. This is the global start time. This is the render start time. This will be the render end time and this will be the global end time. You can know these things by looking at the bottom left corner of the layout. So this is the current time. We are at 324. That is reflected in here. Right now 0 to 1000 frames are visible, which is the global range. Even the render range is set to 0 to 1000. That is the frame range that needs to be rendered. If you see, we have two arrows here, one over here and one here. If we click and drag this forward, you can see 436 is the render end time. Say we drag this here, we have the render start time set to 117. Let's put it back to normal. Now, to set the resolution, we'll go to File, Preferences. We have the global settings and the settings for the current composition. Let's go to the global, General, and activate Autosave. Go to Frame Format, set it to whatever you feel like. I have 1920 by 1080 at 25 frames per second. Actually, this is not so important as Fusion is resolution independent. I'll get to it at a later stage. Save it. Now that we are familiar with the interface, let's get a clip inside Fusion. The easiest way would be to click and drag the clip into the flow area. Now we have the clip inside Fusion, but we can't see anything. We'll just click and drag it into the viewer and you have the clip there. Click on Fit here. Let's actually delete this and look at other ways of getting the clip inside Fusion. The next easiest way is to click on this button here, Loader. We get a window, select the video, drag it to the viewer. Delete that. Otherwise, you can go to Tools, Input Output, Loader. Again, the same thing. Or, you can actually right click over here, Add Tool, Input Output, Loader. So, all of these methods lets you get a clip inside Fusion. Let me delete this. Another way of adding a tool into the flow area is to hit Shift Spacebar. That will bring Add Tool menu where you can search for a tool. I'll just add a background node. Once I type the first few letters, I have the background tool here. Okay, and it's added. If I drag it into the viewer, it's just a black solid. I'll just go in here. This is where you have the settings for this node. So, I'll just go in here, change the color. Click here. Something like that. Next, I'll add one more background node. For that, I'll just Ctrl-C to copy and Ctrl-V to paste. But for this background node, I'll actually change the color to something else. Maybe yellow. And drag this into the viewer. Fit. Other than dragging it to the viewer, we can also click on these dots here to view it in the viewer. Now say I want to see this in the second viewer, I'll click on this dot here. And if I want to see this one in the first viewer, I'll click on the first one. In a layer-based system, we stack up layers one on top of each other. So the one on top will be the foreground and the bottom will be background. So here, let's say this is the foreground and this is the background. So we need to mix this. I want to have some kind of variation for these two so that when we merge it together, we can see what exactly is happening. So let's keep this one just the way it is. For this one, I'll add a mask. So if you go here, you have a polygon mask. This is a B-spline mask, a bit mask, rectangle mask, and ellipse mask. I'll add a rectangle mask for this. If I drag it into the viewer, you have the mask here. And when that mask is applied on this background, you get this. Selecting this mask, I'll click on this solid. Increase the border width so that I get this one. Merge these two. Merge this and this. This should come on top of this. So this is our foreground and this is our background. So to merge these two, I'll add a node called merge node. Shift spacebar, merge node. We have merge 3D and P merge. We'll get to that later. So let's add merge. As soon as this comes in, you see something different with this node. Just like these nodes, we have the output that is a red square, but it has more input nodes. The green is the foreground input node and the orange is the background input node. This is the effect mask input. Once you hover over these inputs, Fusion briefs you about it. I'll connect this to the foreground input and this to the background input. If I drag this into the viewer, see what happens? Let's actually delete this and look at an easier way of adding a merge node. Since we know that this is our foreground, we'll click and drag from this output to the output of this background node. And the merge node will be automatically added. And if you drag it, you get this. Now, say we want this to be our foreground and this to be our background. Connect this to this. So this is connected to the foreground and this is connected to the background. If we drag it into the viewer, we can only see the yellow background. That is because this yellow solid is upon this one. If I just move this to the side, you can see what exactly is happening. So I can go in here and type 0.5 and it will get to normal. Now say for some reason I want this connection to be broken, I can just click here and drag it. Click and drag, the connection will be broken. So that's it for the part 1 of the Fusion Basics video series. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, do put a like and do subscribe. See you in the next.